We're going to be logging some extra data during this session. Nothing you need to worry about, but as we have some new parts on the car, we'll just confirm they're performing to spec. Transmission is significantly damaged. We're down a gear, I'm afraid. You're pushing too hard. It's causing your gearbox to take increased wear. Just be careful. Fastest lap so far, good enough for P3. With that lap, we're P1. Well done.
And with the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Flynn, Leclerc and Lando Norris.
A fantastic drive.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Flynn, Leclerc, and Sergio Perez.
Unnecessary wear to your transmission. Try to take it easy or we're going to risk losing it. fastest lap of the session so far. Great work.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are Flynn, Verstappen, and Charles Leclerc. Welcome to today's sprint. This is shaping up to be another fantastic weekend. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting sprint. Flynn lines up on pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. As we continue...
OK, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Just be careful. Okay, you've lost access to one of the gears. We've lost one of the gears due to a fault in the gearbox. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Good finish. You stepped up and achieved what we asked. Good job.
Flynn increases their championship lead. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. It's time to check out the constructor's standings. No change in the top spot then, but with today's points... Welcome from the beautiful Styrian Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 metres above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of around 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill of turn three. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Flynn lines up on pole position. And it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Lando Norris, and Sainz. Hamilton. Now I wonder, Anthony Davidson, might we be in for some early pit stops today from the midfield teams, trying to put a bit of pressure on or disrupt things for the leaders?
If you're in the middle of the pack, you know, you got your own race to run, I don't think they're going to be thinking about causing trouble up front. However, closer to the head of the pack, don't be surprised to see some split strategies. If you're running second and third, for example, bringing one car in for an undercut while leaving the other one out there longer can put a lot of pressure on the leader and maybe force them into an error.
traffic jams and missed gears. Mark here, you're causing unnecessary wear to your transmission. Try to take it easy or we're going to risk losing it. Right, you might struggle to get into gear at the normal speeds. We're seeing a fault with the gearbox. A good turn in there, mate. That's earned us a decent pit stop time. Okay, DRS is now available. Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Careful. job. You've done everything we wanted today. That is brilliant.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Mercedes. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed. It's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take the top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. So let's see what effect this result has had on the drivers' standings. Flynn increases their championship lead. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
It's contract renewal time, so think about if this is where you still want to be. We can try and negotiate a better deal here, but we also have the chance to look elsewhere. Here you can make salary demands to the team. Any extra over your base salary will go into your perk fund. The more you demand, the lower the chances of our success. Do make sure that you don't go demanding anything unrealistic for your acclaim level. If you do, the team might refuse to negotiate any more with you in this negotiation period.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix. Hey, the marketing team wants to run this one past you. Thanks. I appreciate you taking the time to help out.